We gathered together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ in the love of God, in the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. With humble heart together we say, I confess to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that the course of your world may be directed by your peaceful rule, and that your church may rejoice untroubled in her devotion. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Peter. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in his great mercy gave us a new birth to a living hope through the intercession of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you, who by the power of God are safeguarded through faith to a salvation that is ready to be revealed in the final time. In this you rejoice, although now for a little while you may have to suffer through various trials, so that the genuineness of your faith, more precious than gold that is perishable, even though tested by fire, may prove to be for praise, glory, and honor at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Although you have not seen him, you love him. Even though you do not see him now, yet you believe in him. You rejoice with an indescribable and glorious joy as you attain the goal of faith, the salvation of your souls. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
I will give thanks to the Lord with all my heart in the company and assembly of the just. Great are the works of the Lord, exquisite in all their delights.
The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
He has given food to those who fear him. He will forever be mindful of his covenant. He has made known to his people the power of his works, giving them the inheritance of the nations.
The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
He has sent deliverance to his people. He has ratified his covenant forever. holy and awesome in His name. His praise endures forever.
The Lord will remember His covenant forever. Please stand.
Jesus Christ became poor, although He was rich, so that by His poverty you might become rich.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As Jesus was setting out on a journey, a man ran up, knelt down before Him, and asked Him, "Good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?" Jesus answered him, "Why do you call me good? No one is good but God alone. You know the commandments. You shall not kill. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not bear false witness. You shall not be defraud. Honor your father and your mother." He replied and said to him, "Teacher, all of this I have observed from my youth." Jesus, looking at him, loved him and said to him, "You are lacking in one thing. Go, sell what you have and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come, follow me." At that statement, his face fell, and he went away sad, for he had many possessions. Jesus looked around and said to his disciples, "How hard it is for those who have wealth to enter the kingdom of God." The disciples were amazed at his words. So Jesus again said to them in reply, "Children, how hard it is to enter the kingdom of God. It is easier for a camel to pass through the eye of a needle than for the one who is rich to enter the kingdom of God." They were exceedingly astonished and said among themselves, "Then who can be saved?" Jesus looked at them and said, "For men it is impossible, but not for God. All things are possible for God." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. We come now to journey in ordinary time, and we are now on the 8th week in ordinary time. We could say, my dear brothers and sisters, that this is a time allotted for our lives to concretize and to be realistic about the way we live in all dimensions of our life as we embrace the everyday, the gift given to us, most especially our life. In different forms and different ways, mother, brothers, and sisters, we embrace and we proclaim, we are all entrusted with God's providence and generosity. We are all convinced of all the blessings we receive. This is an unending presence or manifestation of God in each one of us, His providential care. As we take a look at our gospel passage today, we heard a man who asked Jesus, and as to what must he to do to have eternal life? Jesus asked him to part ways in his numerous wealth and give it to the poor. His face fell, and then he walked away from Jesus, for he couldn't obey the request of Jesus. In the latter part of our gospel today, Jesus said how it is to enter the kingdom of God. It is easier for a camel to pass through the eye of a needle than for the one who is rich to enter the kingdom of God. By this, Mother, brothers, and sisters, we are all reminded about our very purpose and how to live under God's generosity, and that is our possession, our material wealth. Ano nga po ba talaga ang layunin ng bawat buhay na kaloob ng Diyos? Ano po ba talaga ang ating paglalakbay? Ano po ba talaga ang ating mithiin sa pang-araw-araw nating buhay? Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, we are all composed, sabi ko po kanina, in different dimension of our lives. Saan tayo nakatuon sa bahagi ng buhay natin? That is why our gospel today, we are reminded of our very purpose of our life every day. At hindi lang doon, binibigyan tayo ng biyaya ng Diyos. At ano ang ating pag-uugali sa mga bagay-bagay na mayroon tayo sa ngayon? We take a breath, we move, and we live with a purpose of which God is very clear that our existence, our presence, it must be worth living. Kailangan ang bawat hinga, bawat galaw, bawat buhay natin ay may kahalaga at mayroong katuturan araw-araw. We have possessions. Mayroon po tayong mga inaangkin na mga bagay-bagay. Sinasabi po natin, hindi natin kayang mabuhay kung wala ang mga ito. Kaya nga, ibinibigay sa atin ng ating Panginoon. And that is the material things, our wealth. Lahat tayo mayayaman. Lahat tayo ay mayaman. But these, my brothers and sisters, these material possessions that we have, we are all empowered to use in order to have a meaningful and worthy life every day. Binibigyan tayo ng mga bagay-bagay na kailangan natin upang magkaroon ng halaga at kaayusan ang buhay natin. Hindi ibinigay ng Diyos ang mga bagay-bagay na ito na mayroon tayo upang tayo ay masira at tayo ay mapalayo sa Diyos. To have eternal life is our primary goal. Whatever we do now and even our status. Kaya po, sabi ko po kanina, dalawang bagay. Yung purpose at yung possession. Ano ang ibinibigay nito sa buhay natin araw-araw? whatever we do now, and even our status, our primary objective, our primary goal is to inherit eternal life. This is our mindset that we should possess every day. Sana ito ang ating disposisyon araw-araw sa bawat pagkilos, sa paggamit ng mga bagay-bagay, nagkakaroon tayo ng buhay na walang hanggan. By doing this and applying this in our lives, Mother Balls and Sisters, you will make the right decision and you are in the right direction of your life, of your journey every day. Putting our possessions in our hands, in our control, use them with the spirit of stewardship, not for hoarding and lording over them. Kasi po, kung minsan sa ating mga priorities sa buhay, nakakalimutan na natin bakit tayo nabubuhay, bakit tayo binibigyan ng buhay. Again, our primary goal, our primary objective is to inherit eternal life. Sa ginagawa mo at sa mga bagay-bagay na mayroon ka, nawa ito'y nagkakaroon ng buhay na walang hanggan. By His trust given for all of us, His goodness, His generosity for all of us, Mother, brothers and sisters, let us always mindful the purpose of everything is to inherit the kingdom of God, to inherit eternal life. And this is a reminder for all of us today and a challenge as we journey today. Let us live faithfully on a daily basis by having God's generosity on our hands to inherit eternal life. We are all rich. Lahat po tayo mayaman sa paningin ng Diyos. If we use them for God's purpose, lalo tayong yumayaman kung tayo'y gumagawa ng desisyon at disposisyon sa mga bagay na mayroon tayo para sa Diyos. Nothing is wrong with being rich as long as we don't make the richness as our God or Lord. And this we can do is best is sharing it to our brothers and sisters. So we should focus on God rather on this world. Let us always remember that we are just stewards of the things that we have today. Amen.
Please stand.
My dear brothers and sisters, we now pray to God our Father for the strength to overcome the temptations placed in our way by the lure of wealth and security. In every petition we say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church may continually show concern and support for the neglected and the downtrodden of our society, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who call themselves disciples of Christ may realize that what really matters in life is concern for others who are less fortunate than themselves. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may find the wisdom of seeking first the kingdom of God and of spending our lives in its service, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick may be consoled and strengthened by Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our deceased relatives and friends may enjoy the victory of Christ in the kingdom of heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In the silence of our hearts, let us now pray for our personal intentions. Heavenly Father, give us the courage to remain poor in spirit and to follow the example of Christ, who became poor so that we could become rich. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for the goodness we have received, the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of the human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for the goodness we have received, the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of the human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who provide gifts to be offered to your name and count our oblations as a sign of our desire to serve you with devotion, we ask of your mercy that what you grant us the source of merit may also help us to attain merit's rewards through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving self a gift, since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so, in the company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy their farthest gifts, we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them like a dewfall, so they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and eternal covenant, which you poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life in the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have blessed worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that by taking of the body and blood of Christ may be guarded to one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, the church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints you have pleased you throughout the ages, we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and I praise and glorify you to your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, our glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we will be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace in unity and accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body of Christ be ministered for the rest of my life. Amen. Let us pray. Nourished by your saving gifts, we beseech you, mercy, Lord, that by the same sacrament with which you fed us in the present age, you may make us partakers of eternal life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless you all. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.